This is Mrs. Knopf, and today we are going to continue in our method book on the alto saxophone with line 22, five-note pattern. And as always, before we get started on this line, we have a fingering chart, and I want to point this out because it is such a cool feature of this method book. The fingering chart that shows up on every page or every other page only has the notes needed on those pages, and that is such a cool feature. I love it. So now we are striving for five, and we have added our fourth line D to the mix. So the fourth line D, we have all of our fingers down except the pinky. So 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. And of course the octave key on the back. That's how you get out the fourth line D, which is concert F. Then we have our third space C. As we've said before, that's just the middle finger, and that is concert E flat. Then we have a B, which is on the third line, just the first finger, and that is a concert D. Then the A on the second space, we just add another finger, so 1 and 2, that's concert C. And finally, our G on the second line, add the next finger, so 1, 2, 3, and that is concert B flat. So you can refer to the fingering chart as you are playing if you need to. It's very helpful. Okay, so now let's look at our five-note pattern. Obviously, by the title, we're going to be using all five notes. So let's go through and see what this pattern is. As always, we start with our treble clef. Then we have our key signature. There's one sharp. It is F sharp. That will never change. If you have any sharps in the key signature, the first one's always going to be an F sharp. It's on the top line, and it tells you that if you had an F to play, it would be an F sharp. But we don't have one of those, so we can also figure out the key based on the key signature. And in this instance, we are in the key of G. We start on a G, and we end on a G. Then we have our time signature. We're in 4/4 time. The top number tells us how many beats are in each measure. The bottom number gives us the value of the whole note. And since we don't have a whole note, we can still use this information to figure out the value of the other notes and rests. So let's break that down. If we had a whole note, it would get 4 beats. Half of a whole is a half, and half of 4 is 2. So the half notes and the half rests get 2 beats each. Then half of a half is a quarter, half of 2 is 1, so the quarter notes get 1 beat each. So now let's look for these patterns. In the first two measures, we are starting on our second line G. It's all quarter notes. We have a G, second line A, third line B, then back down to the A, and then 2 quarter note Gs. G, A, B, A, G, G, half rest. Now we have that same pattern up a step in measures 3 and 4. Now we're starting on second space A, then going up to third line B, third space C, back to the B, and then 2 quarter note A's. A, B, C, B, A, half rest. Now on the next line, we have the same pattern up one more note. So now we're starting on third line B, going to the third space C, fourth line D, all those fingers working, back to the C, then 2 quarter note B's. B, C, D, C, B, B, then a half rest. And then finally, we get to measure 7, and we have our five-note scale descending. So fourth line D, third space C, third line B, second space A, then 2 half-note G's on line 2. D, C, B, A, G, G. All right. So now I'm going to go through and play this with my metronome at 80 beats per minute. Feel free to play along if you're ready. If you're not quite sure yet and you want to hear it first, listen, and then go back and watch this, and then try it. But make sure you start each note with that T sound so you get a clean start to each note. Here we go. 1, 2, ready. quite speak. One, two, ready. Look ahead. Next line. And that is it for line 22, five note pattern on the alto sax. I hope this was helpful, and we'll see you next time.